Hello and welcome to session SAP IS Utilities Solution Training Overview by Simha. Let me start with my self-introduction. I am Simha here, a postgraduate in engineering, M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur, with over 10 years of experience in consulting and training in varied SAP technologies that include sales and distribution, SAP IS Retail and SAP IS Utilities. I have been involved in training over the last 10 years and have, to my credit, transferred the technology knowledge to participants more than 2,500 through classroom sessions, corporate training programs, and also the online training programs. These training programs are designed as per industry requirements and they aim to provide the complete skill set to participants so as to acquire the necessary knowledge and skills to participate in SAP projects. Let me start with a brief understanding of the utilities, the terminology, or public utility. When you say utility, we are talking of a company, an organization engaged in providing services which are called utility services. The utility services include services for supply and distribution of electricity, water, and natural gas. Since most of these services are provided by government, many a times we refer to them as public utilities. So public utility company is engaged maybe in all the four activities of generation, transmission, distribution, and service of the public utilities that are involved. Coming to SAP for Utilities, SAP for Utilities is solution, industry specific solution for vertical industry utilities. It happens to be one of the first IS solutions released by SAP way back in 90s. SAP Utilities was released along with SAP Retail, and today we have a complete solution from SAP, all-inclusive, comprehensive set of solutions, keeping in view of current industry requirements of utility companies. SAP Utilities is a complete ERP system designed to map business processes that exist in utility companies for all the three major divisions of utilities, mainly electricity, gas, and water. To start with, SAP Utility Systems used to be called as SAP ISUCCS, the customer care and service. So SAP ISUCCS provides the ISU components which are integrated with the classical components that are available in a general ERP or current ECC6. So when you look at SAP ISU, it has ISU components which are called CCS components and R3 components. Subsequently, SAP ISU CCS was modified to include so many additional components, but original ISU CCS provided the components like regional structures, master data, which is again divided into two categories, the business master data and technical master data. ISU CCS has got FICA, which is financial accounting, contracts, account receivable and payable. The FICA module is designed exclusively for three specific vertical industries, namely the utilities, insurance and telecom. The FICA module provides a separate subledger accounting system which is exclusively designed for these three vertical industries. Thereby, we can handle the postings for large consumers, which may be in terms of millions. We have something called device management, billing, invoicing, customer service, which is basically the front office, and mapping the customer service activities and work management. Subsequently, keeping in view of the changes that happened in industry, basically the deregulation aspect of the industry, today SAP ISU has the original CCS plus lot of additional components like energy database management, we have intercompany data exchange, and also integration with AMI, the automatic meter reading infrastructure. SAP ISU CCS has full-fledged R3 components which are used throughout the ISU, namely the plant maintenance, and then materials management, sales and distribution, and also warehouse management if required. Coming to the individual components of the SAP ISU CCS, let me start with basic functions. When you say basic functions in ISU CCS, we are talking of the postal regional structures and also the political regional structures. The postal regional structures basically provide the address management, which is used in real estate management. Since in utility business, we have consumers located throughout the regional map, we need to exactly identify the location of the consumer, where the technical objects are located, like device. So we have to maintain the database for all the regional postal structure, which includes the postal codes, the cities, and the street section. And this postal regional structure is integrated in all the important master data like technical objects and also business partner. When you create a business partner, we can enter the postal codes which are validated as per the country, and we can precisely locate the customer for a particular street section in the particular city. So is the case with the connection object, where the connection is provided. The connection object can be identified according to the postal structure, the street section, and the cities. The political regional structures are basically for information sake, and these are designed as per the business requirements or the company's requirements. We also can have a integration between the postal and political regional structures. The another part of basic function which also comes into picture is the scheduling. In case of utility business, one of the most important activities is recording the consumption. For example, we have 10 million consumers, and we need to measure the consumption of electricity for the duration of a month. For this purpose, we have to process what are called meter reading orders. But we have to schedule these meter reading orders in such a way, we will be able to cover all the utility installations as to schedule for the meter reading. Because once you generate the meter reading orders, we have to provide them to meter reading personnel who can visit the place, collect the data, and get back to data entry. So in order to streamline, we have to create what are called meter reading orders, and basically you have to schedule them. For such purpose, we create what are called meter reading units. But meter reading itself is a fallout of the function called billing cycle. We have to fix up the end billing date, and based on the end billing date requirement, we have to schedule the meter reading orders. So in order to schedule the billing cycles, we define and configure what is called the portions. So portions are used for scheduling the billing cycles, and meter reading units are used for scheduling the meter reading orders. So postal regional structures, the meter reading units, and the portions and the corresponding scheduled records form the basic functions in the case of SAP ISU. Coming to master data, in case of SAP ISU master data, we have two categories. One is the business master data and the technical master data. The business master data comprises of three main categories. The business partner, we create business partner using the cross application component, using the partner role and partner category. We use a particular role here called contract partner. Basically, the business partner has a role called contract partner, and this partner can receive one or more utility services from the utility company. For building such contract partners, we create separately a contract account by using FICA component. The contract account provides a lot of flexibilities. We can assign one contract account to a group of business partners or contract holders, or we can have individual contract accounts for individual division. So there is a lot of flexibility in using contract accounts. Contract accounts are possible only if we are implementing FICA, and FICA is applicable only in the case of utilities, telecom and insurance solutions. For the said contract partner, we have to create what is called a utility contract. The contract is division specific. Only when you have the contract for the contract holder, then only you can bill the business partner. The contract account, the contract itself is division specific. So in case a business partner is receiving electricity, gas and water services from a company, there have to be three contracts. And for each contract, we will assign the business partner and the contract account. The business master data is integrated with the technical master data. The technical master data basically comprises of the technical objects which are maintained in ISU. And most of these objects actually come from the plant maintenance module in SAP. The main technical master data would include the configuration and maintaining the master data for objects like utility, connection object, and premise, and then device location. When you say connection object, it is a building or the plant or the location where the connection is given from the utility company. The premise is basically the enclosed spatial arrangement which receives the consumption, could be an apartment like apartment 1, 2, 3. Device location is a location where physically the device are mounted. So the device location shares the same address as the connection object, and the customer who moves in into the apartment will have the address of the connection object. Now we can integrate the business master data and technical master data by having a specific technical master data called utility installation. The utility installation is created for a particular contract partner and it is division specific. In the utility contract, we integrate the contract partner, the contract account, the contract itself, and also the connection object, device location, etc. So technical data together with master data will enable us to do the meter reading for the consumer and subsequently do the billing and then invoicing. Coming to the next important part of the SAP ISU is called device management. When you say device in SAP ISU, we mean in equipment. The equipment itself comes from plant maintenance, but in order to have the device management done in the system, we have the all three modules coming into picture. Basically the materials management, the plant maintenance and SAP ISU. The device management component basically manages the technical data of the devices, device installation, organizing the meter readings and also the quality control or inspection of the devices. Coming to the device management, technical device and connection data, we have to say here, whenever you say device, you are talking of an equipment. Okay. In order to create this equipment, we use what is called a device category. Device category is basically a group of devices which have the same technical data. For instance, single rate meter, two rate meter, smart interval meter. So using these device categories, we actually create the device, and device is created as an equipment with a special category of equipments. But device category is basically again a material, because we need to purchase the device and there are logistic functions like storage. So we first actually create material master, extend it as a device category, and then use the device category to create actually what is called the device. But one of the most important part of device is the measurement. So for this, what we have is the register. So you need to configure and maintain the register data. Sometimes we may have a device more than having more than two registers. In that case, we have to say what kind of register relationship will exist. For example, on-peak register and off-peak registers. Over and above the registers which are basically used for counting, we have non-counting registers like input-output group, command group, and winding group, basically the transformer group. So we have to maintain the technical data based on the configurations what to do in the system. So the technical data and connection data is basically to configure and maintain the device and associated components like registers, etc. Coming to the device installation, In device installations, we have two parts. One is called technical installation, and secondly, the billing installation. When we say device installation, we are recording the system, the particular device with the serial number, where it has been connected. That means we record so-and-so device has been physically connected in the particular device location, which is maintained for a particular connection object, and thereby particular premise and utility contract. So once we know specifically the device, we can find out the exact location in which building it is located, for which customer or which premise that particular device is going to do the meter reading. So once physically the service person installs the device, we'll come back with the details and we record what is called the technical device installation in the system. But in order to bill the device, we have to maintain what is called device billing installation data. Basically the rate structure, the logic by which we are able to bill the particular device. So the rate structure will come under the billing installation, and the technical details like the connection object, the premise, etc. will come under device installation technically. Meter reading is the most important activity in utility service industry. The meter reading is a regular activity to record the meter readings of the consumption. But in order to streamline the activity, we have to generate or print the meter reading orders. The meter reading orders forms the basis on which meter reading results are collected from the actual meters. And once these meter readings are obtained from the actual site where the consumption has been recorded, we have to enter this reading results into the system, and then the system will do the validation. And after the validation, the results are released for the billing purpose. So in the meter to cash process, meter reading order happens to be the first activity. And for this, we have the provision in the system to record single meter reading order, mass meter reading orders, etc. and printing these reading orders for the service personnel. We also have meter reading options by the consumer or entering the meter reading results through web. So these are all the various possibilities that exist for the meter reading. Coming to device certifications, these are basically equipments, so they have got certain calibrated data, but over the years there is a possibility these calibrations will be upset. So in order to make sure our devices are reading correctly, we need to periodically check them and certify the working of the device. So we have the quality procedures coming into picture, sampling procedures, periodic replacement of the device, and also certification. Unless the certification is recorded for the device in the system, the device cannot be installed technically in the particular location. So the certification procedures, the periodic replacement, and for testing, what kind of sampling procedures we are using, all these three together form the part of device certification. Coming to SAP billing, SAP billing is a function which comes in between the meter reading orders or meter reading and invoicing. The SAP IS billing is completely different compared to SAP SD billing. SAP IS billing has its own components. The billing will enable basically to evaluate the energy quantities. Let's say for instance, the consumption of a particular consumer is 300 kilowatt hours. Now how do I bill them? Okay, I need some kind of the rate structure, and basically I use the consumption reading of 300 kilowatt hours to calculate the bill, the value of the consumption for the particular consumer. So IIC billing enables us to calculate the energy values. The IIC billing basically meets the international demands of billing procedures. It provides the various options for billing. Like for instance, the most regular billing that would happen is the periodic consumption billing. Again, we need to maintain different billing procedures for residential customers, non-residential customers, or maybe industrial customers. We have annual consumption billing, or you can use periodic monthly billing cycles. Billing for different divisions, depends. Billing is again division specific. Whatever configurations we do, that configuration will hold good for a particular division. Let's say for instance, I have configured the IIC billing for electricity. It is applicable to only those divisions. We need to separately configure IIC billing for gas division and water billing. Numerous billing forms can be designed basically for processing the output, what you get from the bill. We also can run billing simulation to see whether the rate structure is working properly, if the rate structure is working properly, or if you need some adjustment, after doing that, you can revalidate and then finally go for the billing. And also, there is a procedure to validate the billing documents, outsource the billing documents. So ISU billing forms the most important part of the ISU before you go and do the actual invoicing. SAP ISU billing has four components: the billing mass data, which you also call it as billing engine, the rate structure, the billing procedures. To do the billing, we require the billing procedure. We have to configure the billing procedures, actual billing execution, how we do the bill it, single bill or mass billing, okay? And then additional functions that are associated with the ISU billing. The billing engine or the master data of the billing is the foundation on which you do the actual billing. It is also called as the rate structure. For the given rate structure, we have to configure various components like billing class, the rate type, the rate category, the rate determination, and what kind of operands are used in the rate. Basically, operands are created by operand category like quantity, demand, prices, etc. And then we have to set up what is called the rate determination, something like pricing procedure determination. When you create a sales order, when you want to do the billing, the system will have to determine the rate, and the rate itself is determined based on the rate category and the rate type, and the rate type is assigned to the utility installation. So it's completely different, the method of doing the billing, which is very much peculiar to only the ISU billing. The billing procedures what are widely used will be the periodic consumption billing, the end billing. When the customer does the move out from the particular premises, we do the end billing. And sometimes you have to do some adjustment billing, either for credit memo or debit memo. These will come under the billing procedures. There are some additional billing functions like outsorting. If the bill value is exceeding some value, it will be outsorted. Only when it is released, it will go for invoicing. Reversal functions. Sometimes you may have to create the billings which you have done in order to take care of some additional changes that have happened during the period of time. Manual billing will also include the back billing. That means already customer has been billed and invoiced, but there has been some changes in the tariff which is imposed by the government or the regulatory body. In order to incorporate that, we have to go for the back billing. The back billing comes under the part of manual billing. Coming to SAP invoicing, the SAP invoicing is the next logical process that happens after billing. The invoicing has got various functionalities associated with it. The basic concept in SAP invoicing is the energy values that have been calculated are now posted, and end result of SAP invoicing is generating a FICA document. The system will determine what accounts have to be posted for GL accounts subsequently, but the customer will do the posting to the contract account. The customer payables, customer receivables are updated once you do the FICA document. Under the SAP invoicing, we have got various flexibilities like joint invoicing. I can combine more than one contract accounts. I can combine more than one contracts for one particular contract or one particular contract account into one single bill. We can do the partial bill request processing for your budget billing, okay? Consumption billing. So consumption billing, invoicing, the budget billing, partial bill request, joint invoicing are the very important functionalities in invoicing. Budget billing determinations are also carried out in invoicing. Budget billing is one kind of billing procedures what can be used in the business. Basically, the customer is given the budget billing amounts in advance over the period of 11 months if it is required. And then for each month, we will fix up the amount what has to be billed. And during the 12th month, before going to the next year, we do the calculation based on actual consumption so that the customer will have to pay the additional charges or deductions passed to customer depending on the last month billing. So budget billing, determination, clearing, etc. will happen under SAP ISU, and dates are also determined for budget billing through invoicing component. The tax calculation doesn't happen during the billing process, so the tax charges are determined during the invoice processing. So basically, once you execute the SAP invoicing, we print the bill which has to be sent to customer. The system will automatically update the subledger accounting system, and also it will determine the credit accounts which have to be posted to the main GL when you want to transfer the data from FICA to the financial accounting. Now let me talk something about FICA. We as a SAP functional consultants for ISU will have to understand the components in FICA so that you can do the configuration for account determination. FICA was basically introduced as a subledger accounting system for insurance, utilities and telecom. It's a component basically provided for high volume documents to post, which normally you come across in utilities, insurance and also telecom. The component will provide standard accounts receivable and accounts payable functions, including postings, payments and dunning. So at the level of FICA level, you can see the subledger postings done to the account, and the postings that have to happen to the actual GL accounts available at the FICA. Then periodically we summarize the postings of all these accounts and then subsequently post it to the FI general ledger accounting system, so that we can manage all the open items not at the main general ledger level but rather at subledger accounting system. Now considering the activities what happens in the utility industry, generally you can say there are three main activities. One is the generation of the electricity, transmission and distribution. But over the years, all these three activities used to be done by the government body, the public utility company. But considering the energy demands that arise in the business, in the consumer base today, and a lot of advancements that happen in the meter reading infrastructure, there are deregulations happening globally across the countries. So basically under deregulation, the generation part can be privatized, the transmission alone will be kept with the government or public companies, and the distribution part can also be privatized. Considering this, there is a sort of a scenario where we have to provide some kind of competitive price tariff to the consumers based on the consumption pattern. For example, you may have a consumption pattern like on-peak conditions and off-peak conditions. So rather billing the consumer at a fixed rate of consumption, why not you bill the consumer according to the pattern of the consumption? But this pattern of consumption we have to measure through a proper meter. For this we have what is called the small interval meters. The small interval meters are capable to record and store the data for smaller intervals like 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes. So over a period of day we can have the actual consumption in the form of a curve showing when the on happens, when the on peak happens and when the off peak happens. And then we can provide a kind of method according to which we are billing for the profile. That means we are not billing at the fixed average quantity, but rather fixing the quantity at the on-peak level and off-peak level emerging from energy profile, which is recorded through small interval meter. In order to meet such requirements, SAP provides a module in SAP ISU called EDM, the Energy Data Management. The Energy Database Management in SAP ISU provides the capability to store, to receive and store the consumption data in the form of energy profiles. So profile management is one of the most important part of energy database management. It will help us to create the profiles of different categories and then importing the data from the infrastructure companies who can send the data in the form of various data transfer methods like IDOC, etc. Once the data will come to the SAP energy database, it will be stored as a profile in the system, and then once the data is received, you can do the additional functionalities like validations and corrections, and subsequently use this data for what is called real-time pricing. Okay, real-time pricing can be done based on the RTP interface. The RTP interface can be created according to the actual requirement based on the seasons, period of the time, whether it is the daytime, on time, off peak, etc. These are the some of the things which will come into RTP interface. So during the course of training program, we will learn how to build up the energy profiles, how to actually post this consumption data for a sort of a profile, and then configure the entire real-time pricing using the RTP interface, and finally linking the RTP interface with the billing rate structure so that it can bill the energy quantities according to on peak and off peak coming from the RTP interface. Customer service is an integral part of the utility services. So for the quick access of the data, we have the inbuilt CIC, Customer Interaction Center. Either it can be used as a resident tool, which is available today in SAP ISU. Otherwise, we also can use the CIC through CRM. In that case, CRM has to be connected to SAP Utility System. We can configure the CIC as per the our requirement and use it as working environment for a sort of a cockpit, quick data entry or accessing into the system. The customer service typically involves recording the movements whenever the consumers move into new apartment and whenever they move out. We have to perform what are called the initial reading, meter reading orders for move-ins and also end billing meter reading orders during the move-out. So these will become part and parcel of the customer service, and sometimes because of the nature of the use, the disconnections may be involved or reconnect may be involved. So these activities are actually done through the customer service. Considering the deregulation and emerging trends in the utility industries, today in SAP we also have what is called intercompany data exchange, where several partners involved in the industry, like generating company, the transmission companies and distribution companies, can exchange the data for data settlement of the energy. Okay, so a settlement platform or the workbench is the main important thing in intercompany data exchange. Because of the architecture, we will not be able to do the complete configuration in the system, but we will understand the concept behind the intercompany data exchange by doing the configuration up to one particular level, and the rest can be handled through the overview. Considering the technological advancements in meter reading, today we have the energy meters, interval meters, smart meters, and there are international benchmark procedure companies following the AMI, automatic meter reading infrastructure, and these meter reading infrastructure have to be integrated to SAP. So we will understand what kind of arrangement can be possible and what is the possible available option solution from SAP. These will form the basis for understanding only through the overview. Most complete course for the SAP utilities will be covered on SAP Electricity, SAP Utility Division Electricity. More or less the same concepts are also used in gas billing and water billing. But towards the end, I will be discussing certain aspects of gas billing and water billing as an overview, so that we would have covered all the three divisions, and tomorrow we can be able to use this particular skill set in the particular project. So basically, SAP ISU incorporates the specific components which are required for utility companies. Over and above, it has got all the R3 components, and during the course of time, we will be learning how to integrate and configure these components in along with the components like plant maintenance, machines management, and also configuration with the FICA and then financial accounting. Thank you for attending this session, and I hope this was useful to you. Thanks a lot.